Heavy rain is bringing a sense of unease to many communities that dealt with major flooding earlier this summer. Jessica Hart talked with some of them today about how recovery efforts are going. Jessica?
Julie, the floodwaters have receded in Waterville, but the town still has a long way to go.
It's up to the windows.
In Waterville, Minnesota, there is such a thing as too much.
Oh, no.
Water.
Broke the door.
We fought so hard to keep the water out.
We first met Krista Wolner in June.
And we're doing our darndest.
When she built a 5-foot-tall sandbag wall to protect her home. But the water broke through.
When the water went down, I literally had fish living in my basement rent-free, you know.
But things are starting to clear.
We just finally got hot water Friday.
We still have some street drain issues and we have a lot of repairs to make.
Waterville Mayor Bill Conlon says the Federal Emergency Management Agency will soon meet with homeowners to decide how they can help.
Oh, it's extremely important. When you're in a small town like this, you just don't want anybody to be left behind.
With more rain in the forecast, Conlon isn't worried about flooding because he says the water is low enough. But Wolner can only think about what happened in June.
Whenever I hear there's rain in the forecast, it's kind of like a hold my breath, kind of please no, not again.
She saved a few of the 1,300 sandbags that surrounded her home. The rest created this practical little paradise.
Right now we've got a great sandy area, but we just thought that way when they do bring in truckloads of dirt, it would help offset some of the cost because we wouldn't need as much.
Wolner tells me that fixing her yard is going to be expensive. One bid she got is for $25,000. The mayor tells me that FEMA will set up in the senior center that's right next to City Hall. He says they aren't seeing anyone yet, but they'll get that information out to the public the minute they do. Julie?
All right. Thank you, Jessica.